Laney, and the fact, and Boisco, that the freshmen are expected to be quiet and go into the corner and not be heard. And as a new delegate, do you feel that, or is there progress on that? I'm so impressed with Delegate Lopez sharing with us how you are mentored and how much that must mean to you. So if you could comment on that as a new legislator, I'd sure like to hear from you.
Sure. Thanks very much. Is this working?
Yes.
Okay, great. So thank you very much for having me here, and also thanks to all of you for staying and listening. I know that it's a little bit long. One of the things that I realized during the course of the campaign, because my last name begins in an R, whenever we would be doing events with a lot of people, invariably I would go last. So I'm kind of used to that, except for Kathy. Now, my name's David Reed, and I represent the 32nd District, which is the eastern part of Loudoun County. So it is really wholly contained just within Loudoun County, much like Kathy's district is wholly contained with just in Fairfax. There's only a couple, three of us like that around the state where we have our districts that are all within one jurisdiction. I think it's me and you and maybe somebody down in Virginia Beach.
Patrick Hope.
Patrick, okay. Now, Kathy and I sit next to each other on the legislative floor as well. She normally sits on this side of me, and so if you see us up here talking, it's because we've gotten used to it over the last 60-plus days or so. As far as being told to go and sit and be quiet, there was some of that, but one of the things that was really very helpful was the orientation that Alfonso did and the mentoring that we got from everybody within the Northern Virginia delegation. There was never a time when I didn't feel like I could call anyone up here with any question. My official designated mentor is Kathleen Murphy, who I talk to a lot, and we...
And I take all credit for how
as well she should, as well as Alfonso should for the training.
Are you really that wonderful?
Oh yes, yeah. Yes.
So we look forward to working with you.
So it was really a collaborative effort, and even yesterday I was calling because I was calling and talking to Mark Sickles about something. So it's one of those things where none of us who are the new members felt like that we couldn't call and ask anybody from Northern Virginia. And when you think about Northern Virginia stretches with Winnie-Gadida's all the way out in Clark County, out in the west, all the way to those districts now that are down near the Potomac River. So it's a broad swath of Virginia. One of the things that I like to talk about as far as the lessons learned, there are four things that I really learned as I was going through the process. First and foremost, the most important thing that you must have as a skill as a new delegate is you must be able to do basic math. Because 51 is still greater than 49, and as some of my colleagues have talked about it, everything else flows down from that. The committee assignments, the subcommittee assignments, where the bills get assigned. So if you go down there with the expectation of knowing how that is going to work, then you're able to kind of set your expectations as far as what you're able to do. The second thing is that you have to transition from campaigning to governing. All of those great ideas that you had, all of the great ideas that we had, those things are great when we're talking about them, and then we have to translate those into legislation that's going to change the Virginia Code and then help people that we want to be able to help. So that's the second thing. The third thing is we have to develop relationships. And that's not just a matter of developing relationships amongst ourselves, because there are people that we dealt with a lot during the campaign, but we had new elected members from Prince William County, from down in the Richmond area, from in the southwest part, so and also down in Virginia Beach. So there was new Democrats across the entire breadth of Virginia. But again, going back to lessons learned number one, you have to develop relationships with the Republicans if you hope that you're going to be able to get something through.
For another two years.
But one of those things that I will talk about, because we've talked somewhat about education, and then I'm going to get to number four, is that for those of you who don't know me, I'm the first person in my family ever to get a college degree. And that college degree allowed me to break the cycle of poverty that my family had lived in for generations. Because when I say the first one, I mean since the 1700s. So it is something that made a difference in my life.
We should bring you in to testify on Kathleen's bill.
I'm always there to help. Yes.
Wow. That would be powerful. Thank you.
Yeah, but one of the things that I point out with this is that the cost of college is getting out of control.
Yeah.
And a lot of times we're doing things to address the effect afterwards. We're doing things to try to do things to help with loans afterwards or those type of things. And I took a different approach, which was that I introduced a bill that was going to put a 4-year freeze on college tuition because we needed to have a way to get this under control. That ended up coming out of the Education Committee with multiple Republican co-patrons and a vote of 17-4 before it was referred to Appropriations and then subsequently referred to, well, they referred it to the Joint Committee on Education Competitiveness because they recognized, and one of the Republicans said, this is the simplest, most brilliant way to address this problem. We've been trying to deal with it for years. Now, there are other folks that disagree, but that's okay. It brought to highlight an issue and a way that we need to address it. So the fourth thing, as a freshman, that I learned is that you have to be able to listen. You've got to be able to listen to your fellow colleagues. You've got to be able to listen to the advocates that come in and talk to you, the lobbyists. You've got to be able to show some degree of empathy. And going back to the discussion that we had about some of the economic development activities down in the southern part of the state, I was born and raised in Rockbridge County, so I know what it's like to be poor down there. And so when Will Moorfield's bill came up, it was something that we all wanted to be able to get on to support to try to grow the economy down in Southern Virginia. And think about it, if we grow the economy in Southern and Southwestern Virginia, it helps us as well. Because they're then less dependent upon us for Northern Virginia dollars, and that means we have more money here for roads and for transit and for teacher salaries. So it's to our benefit to help them help themselves. So that's kind of a summary of the broad brush of the four things that I learned from being a freshman. And again, I felt like every piece of legislation that I submitted got a full and fair hearing from the Republicans that were on the committees and the subcommittees. They asked difficult questions, and I will say there were some great ideas that I had when I was in Loudoun County that after I got down there and after a couple, 3 weeks of going through the process, I realized the idea needed to be more fleshed out before it was going to progress. But that's okay, because again, they were still given a full, fair hearing, and those are things that I can work on for 2019. So thanks again, John, you and everybody for having me here.
You speak very, very